Hello everyone, in this video I'd like to talk about InstaFlow from ICLR 2024 that proposes a new diffusion-based text-to-image generation model that can generate high-quality images in a single step, meaning that it is so fast that it can generate images in 0.09 seconds using a single A100 GPU, so let's just talk about it. Diffusion models in general have two sorts of images in their process. One is a noise image, let's just denote it as Z0, and the other is actual RGB image, and let's just denote it as Z1. And our whole goal is to find a transition between these two sorts of images. So in forward diffusion, in a single step, we can transfer from Z1 to Z0, but in backward step, we need multiple small steps to go back from Z0 to Z1. And I was always wondered, why can't we do this backward step in a single step? And when I was reading the original diffusion model paper from 2015, I came across this paragraph that was saying, estimating a small perturbation is more tractable than explicitly describing the full distribution with a single non-analytically normalizable potential function. So I was always wondering why it is less tractable to doing it if you want to do it in a single step. And this paper tries to answer that. But before talking about it, we need to talk about another paper called Flow Straight and Fast from the year 2022. That in the paper, they showed that this transition from Z0 to Z1, it's not a straight line, and instead it is a curvature like this. And to solve this transition from Z0 to Z1, we can define an ordinary differential equation like this. And looking at this equation, we see Z0, which is the noise image, and that comes from the distribution pi0, which is a set of all the possible noise images that we can have. And then we have z1, which is this cat image, and it comes from the distribution pi1, which is the distribution of all the actual RGB images that we have. And we can define a function v, which is the velocity field, that at each step t, we have the point zt, and this function should be equal as the derivative of z with respect to t. So intuitively, let's just say we are at this point zt, and this function v has to estimate the slope. And once we have this slope, we can have infinite small steps, and it starts from z0 and go towards z1. So we need an integral to solve this equation. But in practice, we don't have enough resources to do it infinitely and have this transition from z0 to z1. So one way is just to estimate it using the Euler equation like this. That what it does is that it just divides these steps into n steps, and at each step zt, it just goes towards the output of v, which is the slope, but the step size is 1 over n. And if you do it n times, we expect to see the actual z1 at the end. For example, if n is equal to 4, that means starting from z0, after one step we have this, after second step we have this, and then third step, and hopefully after fourth step we have z1. So now you might guess why we can't just simply start from z0 in a single step and go towards z1. Because looking at the slope, when we are in z0, if we have a big step, then we end up reaching this state, which is different than actual state of z1. So this paper, Flow Straight and Fast from the year 2022, tries to change this transition from the curvature into a straight line. And what is good about this straight line is that we can theoretically find a single step and go from z0 to z1. But in the paper, they didn't solve that, because one of the things that we don't know about this thing is how big our step should be. And instead, they said once we have this straight line, then it is easier for us to converge from z0 to z1, because that's the minimum distance from z0 to z1, just a straight line. So they did like the same four steps, like 1, 2, 3, and 4, but in a straight line instead. And in this paper that I'm about to talk about in this video, they try to find this step, one single step from z0 to z1. So hopefully all the general idea makes sense. So now let's just talk about how we want to deal with this. So the whole goal is just to define this function v. And this function v should be our neural network, a unit architecture, that at each step, it has to give us the output of the slope so that we can move in that direction and remove noise until we reach z1. But how should we optimize this function V? That's what in this paper, Flow Straight and Fast, they defined it as rectified flow. So let's just say we have the curvature, the one that we are usually dealing with, and we want to find this transition from Z0 to Z1. So the way that we should learn this function V is by defining a loss function. And the loss function we use could be something like this, that we need to minimize this expectation. And this expectation is over a pair of x0 and x1. x0 is the noise image, same as z0, and x1 is z1, the original RGB image. And these pairs of data come from a distribution gamma, which the simplest way of defining it would be the Cartesian product of pi0 and pi1, which is a set of all the possible noises and images. So in other words, if you want to talk about in a machine learning terms, we have a pair of x0 as our input and x1 as our ground truth, and these pairs of data should be our whole training data. So this gamma should contain all the training data, and we want to minimize the expectation. In other words, the average of loss function over all the training data that we have. And what would be loss function? It would be this integral. And in this integral, we start from 0, the noise image, towards 1, the original image. And at each step dt, which are just the infinitesimal steps, we need to somehow find this derivative of xt with respect to t, which is the actual slope, and minimize the difference between the true value and the estimated value, which comes from the output of this function v, which is our neural network. So a question that we need to answer now is how we should come up with this function xt so that we can take the derivative and make the output of our model to be similar to that. And the papers like DDIM or probability flow ODEs of Song et al., they just defined some transition that can be generalized and be written as this equation, which if you are interested to see how, you should go and delve into that 2022 year paper. It's all theory, but if you just accept that, we have this xt, which is a linear combination of x0, the noise image, and x1, and the weights are alpha t and beta t, which should be differentiable. So if we differentiate this xt with respect to t, then since this alpha t and beta t are not linear, we end up getting this curvature instead of a single line. So in the paper, they said, let's just come up with something that the derivative should be a single line that connects z0 to z1. And the thing that they came up is this thing, xt equals 1 minus t times x0 plus t times x1. At time step t equals 0, this term would be 0, so we have x0. And at time step 1, this term would be 0, and we have only x1. And if we take a derivative with respect to t, we have this equation, x1 minus x0, which is this line that connects z0 to z1. And yeah, so here that we have the derivative of xt with respect to t, we just need to replace it with x1 minus x0. But the question would be how we should have the pairs of x1 and x0 so as to train the model. And the method that they defined in that paper is called Reflow. So Reflow is an iterative algorithm that updates the parameters of our model without changing the marginal distributions. And by marginal distributions, I mean this Z0 and Z1, so as to change the transition from the curvature iteratively and move it towards a straight line. And the way that they do it is by having this equation. So let's just see what this means. So we have V at iteration k plus 1. It should be parameters of this V that minimizes this expectation. And this expectation is from all the possible noises that we can sample from the distribution pi0. And we also have this fancy T, which comes from DT. And this DT is the data set of the text prompts that we have, because remember, our task is text-to-image generation. And inside the expectation, we have the integral like before, but the derivative of xt with respect to t is replaced with x1 minus x0. And for v, it is conditioned on this fancy t, because we have the prompt as the input, and we want to force the output of the V to move towards the direction to generate the image contains the information and the text. And how do we come up with X1? We say X1 equals this ODE. Once we have the neural network V that receives X0, the pure noise as the input, and this T prompt as the text. And what I mean by this ODE is this equation that we have X0 from the beginning, and then we have this function VK from 0 to 1, and at each time step, it moves towards removing noise one at a time until we reach the actual image. And if we set K to be 1, the V1, we can consider it as a stable diffusion. The thing that we already have, it is a curvature, and we want to refine a stable diffusion to be a line instead of a curvature. So think about it this way. I have V1 as my stable diffusion 1.4, which requires 25 steps to go from Z0 to Z1, and it's a curvature instead of a line. Then I sample a couple thousand X0 as the initial noise samples and give it to the stable diffusion in addition to the text prompts, and it generates a couple thousand X1. And I have the pair of X0 and X1 as my training data. And now I try to refine the parameters of the stable diffusion with this loss function. That for each pair of samples X0 and X1, it forces the denoising process to move in a straight line instead of the curvature. So I train my neural networks for a couple epochs, and for each of the couple thousand data that I have, I force them to move in a straight line. And that way, I move from V1, the stable diffusion one, towards V2, which is the refined version of it, that is hopefully having less curvature than the original one. Now I have the V2, I again sample a couple thousand samples as my initial noise data, X0. In addition to the text T, I give it to my refined stable diffusion and generate some X1. And again, I repeat the process for a couple epochs, and I have V2 now. Then I can repeat it over and over, and hopefully at the end, I reach to a state that can go from any Z0 to Z1 in a straight line. Hopefully makes sense. And theoretically, I need to repeat this procedure infinite times from V1 to V2, V2 to V3, so on and so forth, until I reach the straight line. But they have tried and have seen practically I need only one single iteration from V1 to V2, with a couple epochs in the middle for sure, to have a transition that is almost a straight line. And that's the idea behind that 2022 paper that I just mentioned. And in InstaFlow, they also propose another thing that we can also do, which is called text-conditioned distillation. And in text-conditioned distillation, we say we want to do it in a single step. Let's just say I initialize it randomly, and that single step moves from Z0 to some arbitrary location, and we want to optimize it to move towards Z1, and it is guided by this curvature that we already have from the stable diffusion. So a stable diffusion with 25 steps, it can go from Z0 to Z1, and we use it as some sort of teacher network that help us to move to Z1 into a single step. That is a complete alternative method, right? And the way that we can represent it is this, that we want to find the V that minimizes this expectation. So we have all the X0 noises coming from this pi 0 distribution and this T coming from a DT dataset containing our text prompts. And we want to minimize this D, which is a similarity loss. Or in other words, we want to maximize the similarity between this ODE of V1, the original stable diffusion with 25 steps, and our proposed method, which is X0 plus a single step V that goes from X0 to X1. So we want to learn this V and force it to go towards Z1 in a single step by distilling the knowledge from the ODE of V1, which is the stable diffusion in 25 steps. And the final theory thing to mention in this video is this classifier-free guidance velocity. So if you know the stable diffusion, you know that we can have this classifier-free guidance so as to have a trade-off between the quality of our generation and the diversity. So we have this equation that is alpha times our denoising stable diffusion that receives the text T as the condition, plus 1 minus alpha, that is again our same network that doesn't receive any text prompt as the input. So our denoising diffusion model, without any text, can generate high quality images, hopefully, that are in a very wide diversity. But with conditioning T, we are pushing it towards generating an image that contains that text information. And we can rephrase this equation to be something like this, meaning that we have some alpha, a hyperparameter, and then the difference between the generation with text prompt and generation without text prompt plus generation without text prompt. So if alpha is zero, that means we do not consider the text as the input. It is just a denoising diffusion model without any text. And as we increase this alpha, we are forcing the diffusion model to generate an image containing this text data. And they have used 1.5 for the alpha in this paper. Okay, that was all the theory thing that you needed to know. So now let's just talk about the experiments just to see how it works. So the first experiment, they saw that direct distillation fails. So if I start from the beginning, stable diffusion with 25 steps, that's a curvature, and I want to distill that knowledge to my new V that wants to do it in a single step, it turns out it's not possible. And the way that they tried it is that they trained for 10,000 steps, and for each step, they have used batch size of 32 using 8 800 GPUs. So yes, don't try it at home. You need a lot of GPU just to make it run. And they also have shown that if you want to use one single 800 GPU, you need to train it for 24.65 days, which is negligible compared to other large-scale text-to-image models. For example, the Stable Diffusion 1.4 from scratch requires 6,250 days, or Stiglian requires almost 2,000 GPU days, and GigaGAN require around 5,000 or so. Coming back to the slides, for 10,000 steps that we want to train, and for each of these 32 samples in a batch of data, we need to construct a pairs of X0 as the noise data and ODE of the stable diffusion of X0. So a stable diffusion that receives the noise and give us this X1 as the generated images. And how many training data they generate is, they said we have 10,000 steps and 32 batch size, so we just multiply them and we have 3.2 million training samples, meaning that they only train it for a single epoch, and that single epoch contains 10,000 iterations. And once they trained, they measure FID of 5,000 samples, and then they picked the lowest one for the visualization, which I'm about to show now. It is this thing. So after 10,000 iteration, on the left side we have a stable diffusion, and on the right side we have the distilled one. We can see that the distilled one with a single step, even though it is faster, the generated image is not a high quality image. So the other thing that they tried is that they used Reflow for 50,000 steps, and only one iteration of Reflow, meaning that I start from V1, the stable diffusion, generate 50,000 multiplied by 32 training data from some random X0 and the corresponding T. And then I use it as the training data, and then using this as a loss function, I update the parameters of the stable diffusion. Then I have V2, the updated stable diffusion, that is having less curvature compared to the original one. And once I have it, for the remaining 50,000, I do text condition distillation, the same thing I did before. And I generate a one-step diffusion model that has to imitate the behavior of this ODE, the stable diffusion 1.4. And now with one-step stable diffusion, I can generate this thing. So this 2 from 2 rectified flow comes from V2, meaning that I only need one iteration of reflow. And after distillation, I have this high quality image from a single diffusion step. And they also showed on this figure that you can see with a single step, we can have around 10 times faster inference time, but the FID would be more. Without rectified flow with the original stable diffusion, the FID distance becomes so high that the generated image is not having a high quality. But with rectified flow, the generated image is having a higher quality. And the other thing that they also showed in the paper is this thing, that starting from a stable diffusion that has 25 steps, if I change that 25 steps into a one step, because of having the curvature, it goes to a complete different space and the generated image is all blurry. And with distillation on top of it, I can generate this image, which is kind of makes sense, but it is not containing all the information. For example, the head of the bird is missing. But with 2 rectified flow, have a straight line from the noise towards the original image distribution. In 25 steps, I can generate this high quality image. And in one single diffusion step, since it's a straight line, it goes towards a path that contains the image distribution. But since we don't know how big we should jump, I guess, we cannot generate a high quality image. But with distillation, we can force the diffusion model to kind of learn the step and can generate the image that we actually want. And the final thing I'd like to show here is that InstaFlow is not perfect. We have some issues for the case that the text prompt is complicated, like a dog and a cat shake hands with each other. With the stable diffusion 1.5, we can generate this, but after distillation in a single step, it generates something that doesn't really make sense. And the others say maybe by adding more training data and training it longer, we can kind of mitigate this issue. And yeah, that was all the thing I wanted you to know about this InstaFlow. If you have enjoyed watching this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. And until the next video, goodbye.